down at Pocock HQ today. Mel's doing a bit of a media day today. He's got the guys there just doing some photo shots for him, so we're going to check out to see how the master does it. I'm just in his workshop right now. We're just putting together the last finishing touches, so we're looking after his nutrition today. So we've got his whole shot ready, which he's a sponsored rider for today. So we're going to keep loaded up with this, in this, and get him cracking. So let's see how the kid's getting on, and see how he whips.
Cherry pickers on the way.
I said you're gonna have to blind your dad.
That's so we can get a decent aerial view of this man flying.
Is he gonna get his kit on and ride this for a minute?
Alright.
He won't get much more of a better chance.
Yeah, no. I'll ride it.
Third round like that, give him a little scare up.
He might be getting down.
Go the whip. Look out Wednesday.
You're this way. Oh damn!
You have longer legs.
Shut my balls.
What do I do?
Goggles, Buzz. Take your goggles on, mate.
Go off on the side like that.
But then wouldn't it not go into like...
Just bring it back to here. Don't worry, Buzz.
Put your goggles on, mate. Are you cooking like you were on an 85?
Yeah. Exactly same as your 85.
Yeah, let's help him out.
Right, push that button.
Pull the clutch
in. No, pull it, clutch it.
So we're doing a 20 minute AMRAP right now, so as many rounds as we possibly can with a 40 meter weighted run. They've got the logs, they've got the kettlebells, they've got 20 kilo weight, which Mel Senior dug up from somewhere. I've got Brad, Brett, Mel, they're finishing off the 20. Boston and Ike just finished off a 10 minute one. So this is like about probably 75 degree heat right now, so this is red hot. And these guys are going bang, into, bang at it. We're 14 minutes into the workout already. See, Brett's just off there now, the log. Brad's going off here. Mel's digging deep. So I've had to decide to walk to work today. The van's gone in for a couple of new front tyres. I think four. I think the whole, all four of them are pretty bald. I think the guy referred to them as looking like Kojak's head. So that's not always a good sign. But anyway, so we've got new tyres in there with the van. So I'm walking to the gym. Gonna get in the gym, got myself, Ben and Alan. We're gonna be doing the little menage a trois workout. So I'm gonna show you guys what I kind of do when I get the three of us in a weight session. Primarily we're gonna be working strength stuff today. So we're gonna be doing a lot of pushing. What I like to do is I like to call this the triplex. I stick in an abdominal exercise in the middle. So it gives us a bit of an active rest, but also allows us to hit our core. So at the end of the workout, we're absolutely hanging. You know, we've already done all of our core. I mean, I don't know how many people out there that sort of train and maybe just hit their core and lower back at the end of their workout. But sometimes, you know, you don't tend to sort of give it the right amount of attention that it needs. So I like to kind of hit it whilst I'm fresh, especially on just like upper body parts like chest and back. If I was doing a leg workout, I probably wouldn't throw the core exercises in there, purely because I want my core to be strong, because it's the fixator that's going to support me and keep my form and technique nice and straight. So anyway, I think we're going to do a triplex workout in a second. I'm getting my little bit of cardio by walking. Then we're going to go down later and we're going to go pick up the motorhome. God knows how much that's going to cost. So So I've had a super mega day today. Obviously trained myself and Alan and Ben earlier, which was pretty cool. We did that sort of bit of a chest workout as well, so that was pretty cool. And straight off into that, went straight into the session with the motocross kids, which was good. So managed to get all six of them in here today and just put them through a bit of a mobility sort of workout where we were challenging them through upper body, lower body, learning how to pull, push, travel with their body, all this kind of stuff. So it was really good fun actually, and I think that they got a great deal from it. Also we worked a lot of sort of leg conditioning and stuff as well, so I got them to do some squats with the medicine ball and stuff, and that seemed to work really well because it works very well with motocross. You know, that sort of replicates standing up on the pegs and sitting back down, so conditioning themselves through that range of motion. Then I got on the mats, did a little bit of wrestling. They all managed to sort of test each other as well, so push each other a little bit more, which was good to see, gentlemen, because they're very competitive little buggers, and it's good to see them sort of like start trying to push themselves and work against body weight, which is a great, great thing. So normally they have to wrestle with a motorbike, but at the moment they're sort of wrestling with each other, so it sort of really helps that upper body and that core kind of strength that needs to be developed for motocross. Then I had the luxury of training my oldest. So Ethan came down and we managed to get him on the pads, so he was working some pad work and stuff. You know, we kept the rep range sort of, you know, or the sort of pad sequence, I guess, short ranges. So we should hit 1, 2, 3 reps, 2, 3 punches in each sort of circuit. Just keeping the tempo nice and high, trying to generate a little bit more power through these shots, and at the same sort of time keeping light on his feet. Then put him through a lower body and upper body plyometric strength and conditioning session. So that was really cool. So I'm sure that you guys will see what he's kind of getting on in that session. So good workout, good day.
True spirits, greed, trying to carry further.